गुड मॉर्निंग, माय नेम इज़ गौरव गर्जे एंड आई हैव कंप्लीटेड माय बी इन सिविल इन गुरु नानक देव इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज बीदर एंड आई एम बेसिकली फ्रॉम बीदर एंड आई हैव क्वालिफाइड गेट 2019। नाउ आई एम परस्यूइंग IEEE कोर्स इन प्रयोजना ट्रेनिंग इंस्टीट्यूट बेंगलुरु। थ्रू दिस इंस्टीट्यूट आई हैव गॉट द प्रैक्टिकल नॉलेज और प्रैक्टिकल एक्सपोजर ऑन डिफरेंट फील्ड्स इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग। आई हैव अटेंडेड द क्लासेस ऑन QNQC बाई नटराजन सर। Then I got the knowledge about what are the different types of tests done on the civil engineering construction materials such as cement, sand, concrete, steel, etc. And I got the knowledge about what is checklist and what is the methodology used in the construction. And then I attended the foundation and marking classes by Mr. Suresh Ramaya sir. There I got the knowledge about importance of survey, types of survey instrument used, and the sequence, what is the sequence used in the construction of the any building or project. And then I attended the procurement engineer class by Mr. Ashok Kumar sir, and then I have attended the QS classes and rate analysis, and I have done the BBS on column footing, beam, etc. It was taken by Mr. Mante sir, and then I have attended the MSP classes by Mr. Ganti sir. In that I have learned the MSP software, and later I had the two site visits. First site visit was at B&B Opulent Spire, which is in Jayanagar 9th block, where the construction of G+23 building was going on. And next site visit I had at the Jyoti Institute of Technology, where the construction of auditorium was going on. In there I saw the reinforcement details of slab, beams, columns, and I saw the basement retaining wall. I saw the scaffolding system. I saw the shuttering of beams and centering of slabs. I saw the sunken slab, inverted beam, etc. And then I have attended the session on metro construction, which was taken by Mr. Sridharan sir, who is the project manager in L&T company. Later I have attended the interior classes, which was taken by one of the industrial expert. In there I got the knowledge about the interiors. There are two types of interiors, residential and commercial. In residential we use the different types of units such as wardrobe, kitchen unit, study unit, crockery unit, TV unit, shoe rack unit, etc. And now through the provisional reference I am under the internship in Design Cafe on time study, and through this internship I have got some knowledge about what the actual process generally happens in the company. Once the client who wishes to have the interiors, he will visit the company and meets with the design team. Based upon the client requirements, the design team will prepare the design or drawings. Once this is done, the measurement team or the survey team of the company visits the client site and take the actual measurements and see the position of the sockets, switchboards, etc., and reports to the design team, and the design team once again reworks on the design. And after that there will be the kickoff meeting between the client, project manager and the design team. In that meeting the final design is finalized. Once the design is finalized, it will go for the cut list team. The cut list team, based upon the design or drawings, will do the estimate. Say for example, for one unit, say for wardrobe, how many panels are required, how many hinges are required, and how many handles, locks, etc. are required, what the finishes has to be given. All these are mentioned in the cut list for different units. Based upon this, the budget of the project is prepared by the cut list team. Once the budget is prepared, it will go for the next process, that is for the procurement team. The procurement engineer will procure the materials by requesting the quotation from the different vendors. Based upon the quotations, he will do the comparison statement. After that he will negotiate and finalize the one particular fine vendor. And once this is done, he will the procurement engineer will prepare the internal memo and send to the senior authority. Once the authority approves, he will give the work order to that particular selected vendor. Once it is done, the materials are supplied to the factory. And during my internship program, I had a factory visit at Chandapur, Design Cafe factory visit, which is at Chandapur. There I got the knowledge about the different process which generally happens in the interior factory. First process is the incoming inspection area, and next is the cold pressing area, where the laminate are glued over the plywood and pressed under the cold pressing and kept for about 6 hours that is normally known as curing period, and then it will go for the sawing area where the plywood with laminate are saw, and on each panel the Design Cafe sticker or label is placed. On that, the cut list number, client ID, the panel size to which unit this panel is mentioned, the edge binding code, the boring information, whether the boring is required or not, and barcode. All these information are mentioned in that Design Cafe label or sticker, and later it will go for the edge binding, and then multiple boring area and CNC boring area and grooving process. After that, it will go for the assembling section, where the workers will assemble the panels to form the carcass. After that, the QC team will come and check the quality of the panels and check whether the assembly is done as per the design. And once it is okay, it will go for the packaging. The packaging can be done in two types, flat and box type. If the cabinet or carcass is less than 5 feet, if the height of the cabinet or carcass is less than 5 feet, it will go for the box packing, and if it is more, it will go for the flat packing, and finally it will go for the dispatch. And during the internship, I had the two site visits on two different projects which are going on the same apartments in the Whitefield. In there I got the remaining knowledge. Once the materials are ready from the factory, how they get installed in the site. First, during the unloading process, the factory person, the client, and the project manager or owner will be present. They will unpack all the boxes with the help of the workers, and they will do the panel checking. After that, they will do the segregation of each panels for different units based upon the cut list. In there, I got the knowledge, some more knowledge about the cut list. In the cut, what are the items mentioned in the cut list? In the cut list, there will be the unit mentioned, whether the unit is wardrobe or study unit or kitchen unit, etc. And next, the material description is mentioned, like which plywood is used, such as commercial or boiled waterproof is used. And next, the external and internal finish is mentioned. And next, the cabinet size, that is the length, width and depth, is mentioned in the cut list. Once the segregation of panels and the hardware is done as per the cut list, on next day the carpenters will come and they will start the assembling the carcass with the help of the mini fixing system. And once all the assembling of the different units is done as per the schedule, and once the project is completed, and once the project is completed, and then finally it get handed over to the and finally it get handed over to the client by the company within a given period of time. So thank you.